Keep the questions coming. Inshallah.
Sheikh, I got a quick one if you got time.
Yeah.
Why in the Quran does it, no, I was reading Surah 35, it says we did this and we did that.
Oh, yes.
But when we know Allah has no companion.
Yes. Very good question. You're not the first one to ask this one. And the scholars said, this is the royal we. The queen and the kings and the prime ministers and the presidents, they never say, I do this. They always say, we.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a royal we. And it only comes with blessings. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says we, it means He's giving blessings, so much blessings for all creation. When He says I, it's actually a threat. When He says I, most of the time is not happy about what the creation are doing. So when Allah says Inna nahnu, when we reveal the Quran, we send down the rain, we send down, it means it's the royal we. And Allah knows best.
Thank you.
Jazakallah khair. Obviously, the Sheikh will be with us also tonight. We can ask him to add. Mashallah.
That's good. That's good. You read.
Yes, mashallah, mashallah. Wa alaikum salam, Sheikhna.
Can you hear me?
Yep.
Yes, we can. Alhamdulillah.
Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh.
Wa alaikum salam, Zakareen. How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah. What project are you working on this Ramadan? This Ramadan, you have a project.
I have a few. Few projects.
No, I'm talking about big projects like Cambodia's projects.
Yes, we still have that Cambodia project.
Alhamdulillah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Sheikh Omar, Habibi.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wa man ya'shu 'an dhikrir rahman nuqayyid lahu shaytanan fa huwa lahu qarin. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيَصُدُّونَهُمْ عَنِ السَّبِيلِ وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَنَا قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكَ بُعْدَ الْمَشْرِقَيْنِ فَبِئْسَ الْقَرِينُ وَلَنْ يَنْفَعَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ إذ ظلمتم أنكم في العذاب مشتركون أفأنت تسمع الصم أو تهدي العمي ومن كان في ضلال مبين فإما نذهبن بك فإنا منهم منتقمون أو نرينك الذي وعدناهم فإنا عليهم مقتدرون فاستمسك بالذي أوحي إليك إنك على صراط مستقيم وإنه لذكر لك ولقومك وسوف تسألون واسأل من أرسلنا من قبلك من رسلنا أجعلنا من دون الرحمن آلهة يعبدون. صدق الله.
جزاك الله خير دكتور بارك الله فيك. شيخ محمد تفضل.
على عبادي الذين اصطفى رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من يفقهوا قولي ربنا افتح بيننا وبين قومنا بالحق وانت خير الفاتحين
سبحانك ربنا لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. أما بعد, my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, and children of course, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, thanks to Allah. He has given us another day of Ramadan. How grateful we should be and how lucky we are to get this opportunity to get closer and closer to our Maker, to our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are so super lucky to have this opportunity, and we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time for having this opportunity. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Every day is a new project for all of us. I just heard Sheikh Khaled talking about one of the brothers about having a new project this Ramadan. Actually, for every Muslim, every single minute of Ramadan is a new project. New project to invest more and to have more credit with Allah, credit of good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase and multiply our good deeds. Brothers and sisters, be aware of every single minute of the month of Ramadan. Every fariḍa, obligatory prayer, counts as 70, and every non-obligatory prayer, every nafli prayer, counts like an obligatory prayer. So try to fulfill all the sunnahs, inshallah. Don't miss out any sunnah, any prayer, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the reward as much as you may expect or you may not expect. Brothers and sisters, would like to have some reflections on ayah number 65 from Surah An-Nisa, and this is my first point. Surah An-Nisa is a very lovely surah, and I encourage everyone to read through this surah with translation if you can understand Arabic, with tafsir if you can understand Arabic, to get this beautiful lessons, these beautiful lessons and these amazing insights from this surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this surah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجدوا في انفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما. This is ayah number 65 in Surah An-Nisa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then shift says to him something, and then shift the conversation to address the whole entire Muslim community from that time until the end of time. He said, I take an oath by my own majesty, by your own Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seriously talking about this issue, taking an oath by his own majesty and himself. And this is the second time in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take an oath by himself, which means that it's really, really very serious. And guess what? Both cases, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said to him, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ, I take an oath by your Lord, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will never have a complete real faith until they make you a judge in all dispute. فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. And actually the word shajara is more comprehensive than the word dispute, because shajara comes from the word shajara, which is a tree, which means that issues are very complicated and going everywhere, subhanallah. So it means that we should not resort or go to court or seek legal reconciliation unless we find it very complicated to sort it out. So we have to do our best first to forgive and drop the case and to tolerate and let go of things. When one gets very complicated and we will have to go to court and to find a third party, a legal authority to make a decision about this dispute, then here we go, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best judge. So he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. And not only that, ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ. And after they hear your decision, they shouldn't have any kind of resistance, any kind of discomfort inside their heart, inside their chest, out of your decision. I mean, they shouldn't look at your decision with any kind of discomfort or any kind of dislike. They have to accept it. They have to accept your decision with the fullest acceptance and submission. And they submit completely. Brothers and sisters, this is a really very great principle of our religion. that we follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and take him as a model example. He will never misguide us. He will never speak anything out of injustice or out of his own desire. It is all revelation. So this actually ayah was revealed when there was a case between a Muslim and non-Muslim, and Rasulullah sallallahu made his decision according to the truth and nothing but the truth, because he was always just and fair, and this decision was not actually the favorite decision for the Muslim, the one party of this dispute. So he didn't like it, and he thought that Rasulullah is going to favor him, but he didn't understand that Rasulullah is fair and just, and we have to be fair and just with everyone, with anything, even with our own children. We have to be very fair and just. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns the Muslim that if you reject the decision of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and if you dispute his own decision, his own choice, then there is something wrong with your faith, subhanallah. And this will happen only accepting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's decision with full submission will only happen if we have this great love to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's another principle of our religion. We cannot be completely Muslims and believers until we love Rasulullah more than we love our own selves, our own parents, our own children. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa said, لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ نَفْسِهِ وَمِنْ وَالِدِهِ وَوَلَدَيْهِ وَوَالِدَيْهِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. None of you will have complete faith until he loves me more than he loves himself, loves his own parents, loves his own children, and loves the whole entire mankind. Subhanallah. Imam Ibn Jarir, rahmatullahi alayh, one of the great commentators on the Quran, he mentioned that story that happened at the time of the Mongol, Al-Maghul. Those people were very tyrant and very aggressive and violent people. And subhanallah, one of their leaders accepted Christianity. And when he accepted Christianity, being a leader and a general of an army, the priests and monarchs got together around him, and they start like praising his choice to be a Christian, and they started like insulting Muslims and the Prophet of Islam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just to show him that he was right to invade the Muslim countries and kill hundreds of thousands of Muslims, justify that for him. So one of those extremist people was talking about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam with a lot of abuse and insult. So all of a sudden, a dog came out of the crowd and he started attacking this man. So the prince or the general looked with a lot of curiosity, what is happening? Why this dog attacks this man once he started talking bad about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The man said, no, it's just like because when I pointed out to him with my hand, he got afraid and he ran away. So he repeated his speech and he started doing the same thing, insulting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the dog came back again from his place and started attacking him. And that time the people could not save his life, and the dog managed to kill this man, subhanallah. You know what happened? This general understood that it's a very powerful message that Islam is the truth and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the right messenger of Allah. He embraced Islam instead, and hundreds and thousands of his followers accepted Islam, and this was an end to the war between Muslims, or a kind of pre-stage to the end of the wars between Mongols and Muslims and their conversion to Islam. So brothers and sisters, try to make Rasulullah your own judge in everything. Resort to his sunnah, go back to his sunnah, to his guidelines, to find a decision about your own life choices. If you have to make a choice about anything, make Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam your role model, and have nothing in your heart against what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses for us, or what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chooses for us. The second point, very quickly, I'm running out of time. My tip today for the fasting people to make the most of Ramadan, it is to revive the sunnah of Qailula. Qailula is to take a nap during the daytime. And guess what? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قِيلُوا فَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَا تَقِيلُ. Go take a nap during the daytime, even if it's 14 minutes, 15 minutes, because devils do not take nap. They keep running all the day around. Why, brothers and sisters? this very short time of sleep will give you energy at night, so you will make the most of night time. You will be fresh, and you may get the opportunity, inshallah, to stand privately privately in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give a quality time of meditation and dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what this is required. Keep in mind that the nights of Ramadan are more important and more precious than the days of Ramadan. Even though we are fasting on the daytime, but night times are very special because the night of Fajr is one of the nights of Ramadan. So being energetic and vivid and awake at night requires you to take some kind of preparation during the daytime. And the best thing to do is to take a nap during the daytime and fulfill the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The third point quickly, what is the khuluq, the character that we will try to bring in our life tonight? It is the character of positivity, al-ijabiyya, to be a positive person. What does it mean to be a positive Muslim? Three things. First, to be worried and concerned about this religion. It's yours. It's your own job. It's your own responsibility to bring it to your life and the life of the people around you, to maintain it, to promote it, to propagate it, to support it, subhanAllah. Even if you think it's pointless to try because it's very, very, very corrupted around you and it's very hard to get into the hearts of the people at that time of miss, I would like to remind you, this is not acceptable excuse because the believers in the worst of scenarios have to fulfill their duties, being worried and concerned and feeling responsible for this deen. مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ I'm doing that because I want to have an excuse in front of Allah on the day of Qiyamah when he asked me about this religion, what has done for this religion, subhanAllah. The second thing, to be a positive person, is to be proactive. To be proactive means to take a step forward. Don't stand idle and say, okay, it's not my business, I don't care, it's not my job and duty. This is the job and duty of the sheikhs, the ulama, the scholars. It's everyone's duty. The Quran tells us about a single person who believed in Allah and believed in Prophet Musa alayhi salam, and he challenged Fir'aun, the biggest on earth, the most powerful king of his time, the strongest man of all ages, subhanAllah. He challenged him and he didn't care about what would happen to him. Why? Because he knew that he has to be a proactive person. Habib al-Najjar, Mu'min Ali Yasin, he was also a believer who challenged his people and they executed him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told his story briefly in Surah Yasin. And the last word is of his when he said, قِلَ ادْخُلِ الْجَنَّةِ قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِي يَعْلَمُونَ بِمَا غَفَرَ لِي رَبِّي وَجَعْلَنِي مِنَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ I wish my people who executed me and tortured me because I advised them to believe in Allah if they would know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded me for my patience and my iman, they would have followed me. But anyway, I've done my job anyway. So you need to be concerned and worried. You need to be proactive. And at the same time, you need to stand by your own, by the truth, to be straightforward. Do not follow the people. Rasulullah s.a.w. said, لَا يَكُونُ الْمُؤْمِنُ إِمَّعَ The believer shouldn't be a blind follower, a copycat. إِنْ أَحْسَنَ النَّاسِ أَحْسَنَ If the people are doing good, he will do good like them. وَإِنْ أَسَاءُ And if they miss up, they will miss up as well. So he will just follow the people and say, I'm just one of them. No, you have to stand by the truth. You have to be yourself. You have to follow the right line, the right way, and you have to follow the straight path, even if the whole entire earth is going against the truth. It's not your choice. You have to stand firm. Rasulullah ﷺ continues to say, وَلَكِنْ وَطِّنُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ أَن تَقُولُوا Then prepare yourself to say, إِذَا أَحْسَنَ النَّاسُ أَحْسَنَّا وَإِنْ أَسَاءُوا أَحْسَنَّا If the people are doing good, we do good and support them. If the people are messed up, then we are still doing the good and we keep advising the people and helping them out. Brothers and sisters, I come to my last point now, which is the dua. Tonight, inshallah, I'm going to share with you a dua, but this time in the ruku'ah. Ruku'ah is also a very, very important position that in the salah, we have two ruku'ahs every, we have one ruku'ah in every rak'ah, and we do this ruku'ah at least, subhanAllah, 17 times a day. In Ramadan, we do it more than that. So it is better to learn more du'as for ruku'ah. The dua is today, of today says, Allahumma inni laka raka'at. Allahumma inni laka raka'at. Wa bika aman wa laka aslam. Khasha'a wajhi. الذي خلقه وصوره وشق سمعه وبصره وعظمه ومخه وما استقلت به قدمي خشع لك سمعي وبصري ومخي وعظمي وما استقلت به قدمي خشع لك سمعي وبصري ومخي وعظمي وما استقلت به قدمي I bow in front of you, O Allah, and I humble myself in front of you, and to you my eyesight humbles, and so is my hearing, and my nerve, my bones, and whatever my feet mount for a ride or for taking a transport. So this dua will be on the website, inshallah, soon, and please try to memorize it and use it in your ruku'. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept. Allahumma rabbana taqabbal minna wa qabalna وعافنا واعف عنا وتوب علينا واسامحنا واغفر ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا وتولى أمرنا يا رب العالمين واجعلنا من عتقائك من النار ومن المقبولين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
ما شاء الله, جزاك الله خير شيخنا, بارك الله فيك, فتح الله عليك. So I got one question today on the website, but I will open it to the brothers and sisters if you want to have a question before I read my questions from the website.
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Wa alaikum assalam.
It's Nili here. Wanting to know about that night time in the month of Ramadan, which you just mentioned is better than the day. Does it mean that you have to do it after Taraweeh and then you go to bed and then just wake up an hour before Fajr? Or does it mean you go to bed after the light, Qiyamul Layl? Because Prophet Muhammad SAW always like to go and advise to go to bed after Isha. And then you wake up like say 2 or 3, 2 o'clock in the morning. Which one is the best time?
Well, generally speaking, the night starts from sunset until the Fajr time. So this all these hours, these 12 hours, is better than the 12 hours of the daytime, and you can use it the way you want. So you may just break your fast, sit down and read Quran, prepare for your Isha and Taraweeh, and then after that, after Taraweeh, you go for a sleep, take some rest, and then wake up again after midnight and do some more prayers, tahajjud, until Fajr, or you can use your time the way you want. But the point here is, during the daytime, you are so busy with so many things. So you are distracted with so many things. And you have to be distracted because of your family, your community, your work. But nighttime, you can give quality time to Allah by standing. Even if it's only for 15 minutes, 5 hours, 5 minutes, 1 hour, whatever time you can afford, but it will be a quality time. You'll have a quiet mind and quiet time, and also kind of very, very attached heart to Allah. That's why it is better, right? And so you can divide the night the way you want. It's up to you. But of course, you have mentioned something great, which is sleep after Taraweeh in Ramadan, and then you can wake up after that, do your night prayer, whenever you find yourself able to do so. But of course, it's better to be close to Fajr time.
Jazakallah khair.
Yeah.
Sheikhna, there is one question that came on the website. If fasting Ramadan is compulsory for the adults, why are the children fasting?
The children should start learning about fasting and prayer and other pillars of Islam from early age, so they get customized and get used to. So we don't say that they have to fast. They only have to fast when they reach the age of puberty, not before that. But before that, we are advised as parents and caregivers to train them. So they get used, they get customized. And slowly, it becomes easier for them by practice. And then when the time comes, when they have to fast, they find it easy. So that is the point. That's why we make them fast, just for training. But we don't have to force them. We don't need to force them to fast. We can train them slowly, few hours, few days, until they are strong enough and able to do the fasting the whole month. And that should be by the time they reach, inshallah, the puberty, or maybe before that, that should be better. And they still get reward, even if they don't have to. They will get the full reward of fasting people, fasting others.
Jazakallah khair. Beautiful, mashallah. Thank you so much. Jazakallah khair. Brothers and sisters, any more questions before the Sheikh go and finish his 36 rak'ah?
Assalamu alaikum. I was just wondering, Sheikh, you were talking about doing projects. So I was wondering if a Muslim can kind of initiate a project related to the world knowledge, not Islam or religion. Would that be considered ibadah in the Ramadan, or would it, or it's not really recommended and it's preferred to spend it in worship? I'm sorry, I can't hear you, Sheikh.
Al-Hikmah, Dallat al-Mu'min, aynama wajadaha, fahuwa ahakku al-nasi biha. Which means Hikmah, which is knowledge. Any beneficial knowledge is our loss to poverty. So whenever we find a field of knowledge, advancing the humanity, advancing the life of humanity, and benefiting the people, then we're supposed to be the pioneers in this field, which requires us to do more work and more effort than anyone else in the world to promote and enhance this kind of knowledge. It's not only about Islamic knowledge. If we read about our own history, and the greatest time of the Muslim civilization, we find Muslims mastered these knowledges, sciences and knowledges, and they were pioneers, and they led the world for them. So it's not always about just religious sciences, but it's all about beneficial and useful sciences and knowledges that will benefit the humanity.
Thank you, Sheikh.
Jazakallah khair, mashallah. Yeah, going once, going twice. The Sheikh is still sitting down. Mashallah. Just also on that point about the knowledge and the day and the night and what is better, sisters who are cooking and washing and looking after the families, that's an act of worship.
Yes.
Brothers who are working, driving or working in office, whatever you are, it's an act of worship. You get reward in Ramadan, inshallah. Kids who are studying, going to school, doing the homework, you get reward for every minute while you're fasting in Ramadan, inshallah. So this is in Islam, 24/7, you even sleep can be an act of worship. Yeah, inshallah. Jazakallah khair, Shaykhna, barakallah feek, hafizakallah. Just before we finish, on this beautiful note, inshallah, we have two stars in the group who started to memorize the dua. They are, you know, the youngest maybe in the group. One is Ibrahim Saqib, and the second is Mirza Nickling Sons, mashallah. May Allah bless you, protect you. And we, inshallah, tomorrow we have Sheikh Naseem is coming to join us. So we're going to have Sheikh Naseem, Sheikh Muhammad, Sheikh Omar, mashallah. Soon enough, we will have the whole rugby team of Shiuch.
Inshallah, inshallah.
Sheikh Naseem is coming tomorrow, so prepare your questions. He's coming to see all of us, inshallah. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh. Barakallah feek.
Barakallah feek. Wa feeka barakallah.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Sheikh. Jazakallah, Sheikh Dr. Omar.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh. Jazakallah
khair. Hafazakallah, Sheikh. Barakallah feek. He comes to this, mashallah. So this, we're waiting for you. Come and make a dua, so this.
I mean,
mashallah.
I want chocolate.